today in God's house, I will probably veer off of what you're normally used to because I'm not used to what you do, but we will carry on because this is God's table, not ours. And in true United Methodist fashion, everyone is welcome to the table. You don't have to know God, you don't have to profess anything, you just need to come and accept God's love. Christ our Lord invites all who are beloved children by God to this table. Christ washes the feet of those who were wounded and fallen, and those who were crying and those who were shouting, and all who kept asking questions. And Christ invites them to this table of God's love. I invite you to the table of Jesus. As we begin our time, let us begin with prayer. May God be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts to God.
Lift up to God.
We give thanks to God. It is a right and good that we offer thanksgiving in all places and in all circumstances to you, Almighty God. You have created the heavens and the earth, and you created us in your image and gave us our very lives. We are children of God who live in your love. When we turn away and our love fails, your love remains steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, of fear and hatred, and made a covenant to be our sovereign God. And through Jesus, you gave us new life in the Spirit. Also, you created your church to carry on your work in the world. Let us now pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. On the night in which Jesus gave himself up for us, he took bread. He gave thanks and broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts of Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in thanksgiving and in union as living sacrifices with Christ's offering for us. As we proclaim the mystery of our faith, Lord God, pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and juice. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your Holy Church.
Amen.
And I believe John is going to come forward. Thank you.
No.